very fine morning. Praise the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And I thank the leadership for giving me this opportunity to speak to us. Hallelujah. It is an honor. It is an opportunity. It's actually a blessing. Praise the name of our Lord Jesus. Praise the name of Jesus. Now today I want to speak to us about a very important topic. Praise the name of Jesus. A very important topic in the life of a Christian, in the life of a child of God. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. In the life of someone who is in the kingdom of God. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. It is very connected to the kingdom of God. Praise the name of Jesus. It is very connected to the kingdom of God. And that is called faithfulness. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. We are talking about faithfulness. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. I know we all know by definition what faithfulness means. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. What it entails. Hallelujah. So I'm going to level this, the topic of my sermon today, being faithful where you are. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Is what I'm talking about, being faithful, does not need you to switch or to change positions. Hallelujah, for you to be faithful. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. It has nothing to do with your position. Praise the name of Jesus. It has nothing to do with your financial abilities. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. It has nothing to do with you being rich or with you being poor. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. It has nothing to do with you being in the city, and it has nothing to do with you being in the village. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. The matter of faithfulness, hallelujah, it is something that every child of God can do. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. So today I'm talking about being faithful where you are. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Now, before we go any further, you should ask yourself, where are you right now? Praise the name of Jesus Christ. So when God descended, hallelujah, in the Garden of Eden, hallelujah, he asked Adam, where are you? Praise the name of Jesus. Now that is the first point, hallelujah, for you to enter or for you to understand this word called faithfulness. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. You must know where you are. Hallelujah. That is the first point. You must know where you are, because that is connected, Ratoros. That is connected with you knowing who you are. Hallelujah. So faithfulness depends with you knowing. It takes knowledge. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Knowledge of where you are. Hallelujah. So once you know where you are, then you can know what to do. Praise the name of Jesus. You can know what not to do. Praise the name of Jesus. So when God was asking Adam, he was asking him to know. Praise the name of Jesus. Because he wanted Adam to know. That question was not directed to God, because God knows where everything is. God knows you, hallelujah, from inside and out, hallelujah. His eyes are everywhere. He is omnipresent. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. So that question was for the help of Adam. So I'm going to ask you today, where are you? Hallelujah. Because that question is very important for you to be faithful. Praise the name of Jesus. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Now I'm going to couple it with this character. I'm going to give us an example for us to understand it better. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. We're going to take one example. Hallelujah. We can take more than that. Praise the name of Jesus. We're going to take this man called David. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. David. The Bible says that David was a man after God's heart. Hallelujah. Now people usually speculate, what made David to be a man after God's heart? What made David to be after God's heart? What gave him that label? What gave him that title? Hallelujah. So there are usually very many things. Hallelujah. But one thing that I believe that made David be given that name, that title, a man after God's heart, it was because of his faithfulness. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Now look at the beginning, hallelujah, of David. Praise the name of Jesus. The Bible says that you should not despise La Rosa. You should not despise the small beginnings. Hallelujah. So once you do not despise small beginnings, you're going to understand, you're going closer to what I call faithfulness. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. People who are faithful do not despise small beginnings. Praise the name of Jesus. So when David began, he began as a shepherd boy. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. That is where God began with him. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. In this journey of faithfulness, praise the name of Jesus Christ. Now when we talk about faithfulness, it means God is going to give you something. Hallelujah. And that something can be very small. It can be very insignificant to you. It can be very insignificant to people that watch over you. Praise the name of Jesus. But I tell you, it is God who is now watching to see if you are faithful or if you're going to be faithful or not. Praise the name of Jesus. So we can see this man David, hallelujah, in the small beginning that God gave him, he did not despise it. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. That is why he appeared or he came out to be faithful. Hallelujah. In what he was given by his physical father. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. His father gave him sheep to tend. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Sheep to tend. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. To feed them. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. So even in your journey of faithfulness, hallelujah, God is going to give you some things. Hallelujah. To feed. Hallelujah. So he is going to give them to you small. Hallelujah. Just as David was given the sheep hungry. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. He was not to return them home hungry. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. He was going to bring them back fed. Hallelujah. Healthy. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. And well protected. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. So God is going to begin small with you. Hallelujah. He's going to give you something very small. Hallelujah. If you look it with your own physical eyes, you're going to see it as insignificant. Praise the name of Jesus. But I tell you, that is the test of faithfulness. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Amen. That is the test of faithfulness. Hallelujah. So if you do not despise that small thing, that small beginning that God has given unto you, then you are going to move into a place of faithfulness. Hallelujah. But if you despise that small beginning, then you are going to fail in the test of faithfulness. Praise the name of Jesus. Now that brings us to the question, what has God put into your care? Praise the name of Jesus Christ. What has God put into your care? So that will take you to scrutinize your life. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. To watch, hallelujah, it might be a gift. Praise the name of Jesus, that God has put into your spirit. Hallelujah. Now, he will not give you big, as you may think. Praise the name of Jesus. But he's going to give it to you small. Hallelujah. Maybe he has just given you praying in tongues. Hallelujah. You can look at it and see that it is very small. Hallelujah. Because God usually gives it to you as a seed. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. He's going to give it to you as a seed. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Just as he gave you faith, praise the name of Jesus Christ. The faith that he gives you, he does not expect to find it the same way he gave it to you. Hallelujah. You are supposed to feed it. Hallelujah. The Bible says that faith comes and but by hearing, and but by hearing by the word of God. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. So even in this journey of faithfulness, praise the name of Jesus Christ, even in this journey of faithfulness, you are supposed to be diligent. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. To increase, hallelujah, that which he has given unto you, you are not to return it the same way it was. Praise the name of Jesus. Now what am I saying? I'm saying that the gift that the Lord has given unto you is not expected to be the same way he gave it to you yesterday. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the name of Jesus. The gift that God has given unto you is not expected to be the same way it was yesterday. It has to improve. Now that brings you to that question. Is your gift improving? Is your ministry improving? Is your talent improving? Praise the name of Jesus Christ. That will determine if you're moving well in the path of faithfulness. If you're moving well in the path of faithfulness, praise the name of Jesus Christ. Now look at it very keenly. Is it increasing? Is it growing? Praise the name of Jesus. The Bible says in 2 Peter, it says that to your faith add, hallelujah, to your faith add something. Praise the name of Jesus. You are going to add knowledge. You're going to add virtue to it. Praise the name of Jesus. Let us take the first step. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. It will take faithfulness. Hallelujah. It will take faithfulness. And that faithfulness that I'm talking about, you will have to value. Hallelujah. What you value, you will be faithful in. Hallelujah. What you value. So it will take value. The Bible says, do not despise small beginnings. Praise the name of Jesus Christ.
So God gave you faith, hallelujah, as a small beginning. So if you despise your faith, praise the name of Jesus Christ, you are not going to improve. You're not going to be diligent to add value to it. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. It means you are not a faithful servant. You're not a faithful steward of the faith that God has given unto you. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. God has given you faith. What are you doing with your faith? God has given you salvation. What are you doing with that salvation? God has given you that gift. What are you doing with that gift? God has given you that ministry. What are you doing with that ministry? Are you faithful? Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Now your faithfulness will determine if God is going to increase you in that gift or not. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. So if your faith, hallelujah, if you add to your faith virtue, because that is what God wants from you. He wants you to deal diligently with the faith that God has given unto you. Now that faith is your salvation. Now the question is, what are you doing with your salvation? Are you sitting with it, or are you doing something with your salvation? Is your salvation bringing someone into the kingdom of God? Is it increasing the kingdom of God? Now that is what faithfulness is all about. It is about increasing, hallelujah, the kingdom of God. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. That is why God gave you salvation, to increase his kingdom. So if your salvation is not increasing his kingdom, then you're not being faithful. Praise the name of Jesus. It means you're not being faithful. Hallelujah. It means you're not being faithful. So faithfulness is very key. Hallelujah. Why am I talking about faithfulness? Because faithfulness will determine if you're going to be in the kingdom. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. It is going to determine. Now if you connect it to what Peter is saying, he's saying to your faith, you add power. Hallelujah. He says to your faith, add power. Now for you to add power to your faith, then it will take an action. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. The Bible says that faith without works, hallelujah, is useless. It is dead, hallelujah. It cannot release power. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. So even in the journey of faith, praise the name of Jesus Christ, it will take faithfulness. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Now faithfulness is adding works, is adding actions to your faith. Hallelujah. It is not just talking. It is not just that I'm saved. Hallelujah. Now what shows that you're saved? Hallelujah. That determines if you're faithful or not to the faith that God has given unto you. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. So you should ask yourself, are you faithful with the faith that God has given unto you? Praise the name of Jesus Christ. As I say, it will take diligence. Diligence means an action. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. It will take an effort. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. God is looking for faithful people. It is only faithful people that increase the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. As I say, your faithfulness will determine if you're going to be in the kingdom or you're going to be outside the kingdom. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. So you must be faithful. It is not an option. You must be faithful. Hallelujah. Faithfulness is a must in the kingdom of God. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. It is not something that you're going to choose. It is not something that you're not going to decide to do or not. Hallelujah. You must do it. Hallelujah. Because if you're not faithful, then it means you're not fit for that kingdom. Hallelujah. And you're not fit to get that which God has given you. It just means you have despised that faith. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Now let us move to another example. Now this man is called Esau. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Now Esau despised his birthright. Hallelujah. God gave him a birthright. Hallelujah. He gave him that responsibility of a firstborn. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. But he despised it. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. He despised it. Now even as I've said, that you should not despise small beginnings. So Esau despised the small beginnings. And we do know that what you despise, you do not value. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. And what you do not value, you can trade with anything. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. What you do not value, you can trade with something. And what you're trading it with, I tell you, it must be of low value than what you are selling out. Hallelujah. So he failed in the test of faithfulness. He was not faithful with his birthright. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. He was not faithful with his birthright. And because he was not faithful with his birthright, he lost it. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. So ask yourself, are you faithful with that gift that God has given unto you? Are you faithful with your salvation? Are you faithful with the gift of prayer that God has given unto you? Praise the name of Jesus Christ. God has given you the power or the grace to pray. Now, is your prayer increasing the kingdom of God, or is it decreasing? Is it pushing people inside the kingdom? Is it pushing them away from the kingdom, or is it pulling them into the kingdom? Now, that will determine if you are a faithful servant of God, if you are a faithful servant of the kingdom. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. So, because Esau despised, hallelujah, because he despised his birthright, he lost it. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. And the Bible says, even when he came with repentance, with tears, he could not find it. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Why? Because he lost it. And if you lose it, you will not get. Because whatsoever you despise, you are not worthy of. Hallelujah. Whatsoever you despise, you are not worthy of. Now there are some very many things that God has given unto us, even as his children. God has given you life. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. He has given you physical life. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. He has also given us a provision to spiritual life. Praise the name of Jesus Christ, which is eternal life. Hallelujah. So eternal life depends with your faithfulness. You have to be faithful. As I said, you have to be faithful with your faith. Hallelujah. For it to come to maturity. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. So we can see of why or how God loved David. Why did he love him? Because he was faithful. He was a faithful shepherd. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Now the second thing that you will have to do when you are faithful, you will have to guard that which God has given unto you. Praise the name of Jesus. Now God has given you an anointing. Hallelujah. Are you guarding that anointing? Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Are you guarding that anointing? Now this is what John says. He says that they that are born of God, they keep themselves that the evil one do not touch them. Hallelujah. That the evil one do not touch them. Why? Because they value themselves. Hallelujah. They value the gift of God that is in them. Hallelujah. Now, which gift is that? God has given you an anointing. God has put his anointing inside of your spirit. Praise the name of Jesus. But the Bible says that when he, the Spirit of truth, shall come, he shall be in you and he shall be with you. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. So it means you have an anointing. Because you receive Jesus Christ, you have an anointing. Now the question is, are you faithful with that anointing? Praise the name of Jesus. Are you faithful with that anointing? Now what do I mean faithfulness with that anointing? Are you guarding it? Praise the name of Jesus. That which you are faithful in, you will guard. Hallelujah. You will not joke with it. You will not play with it. Hallelujah. Now this is what the writer of Ecclesiastes says. He says that, praise the name of Jesus. Ecclesiastes 10. We are talking about faithfulness. Thank you, Jesus. Ecclesiastes 10, we are going to read from verse 1. Praise the name of Jesus. The Bible says, dead flies cause the ointment of the apothecary to send forth a stinking savour. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. So does a little folly him that is in reputation for wisdom and honour. A wise man's heart is at his right hand, but a fool's heart at his left. Hallelujah. So he says that dead flies cause the ointment of the apothecary to send forth a stinking savour. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Now God has given you an anointing. Hallelujah. That anointing is in your spirit. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Now the Bible says that dead flies, it is what contaminates that anointing. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Now what are those dead flies? He explains it. He says that so does a little foolishness, decisions. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. For you to be a faithful, for you to be faithful in your anointing, then you have to be very careful with your decisions. Praise the name of Jesus. He says, a little folly, him that is in reputation for wisdom and honor. So just one thing, if you do one thing foolish, you're going to bring you're going to dirty your reputation. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. You're going to dirty your reputation. You're going to interfere. You're going to contaminate your anointing. Hallelujah. So are you a faithful keeper or preserver of the anointing that God has given unto you? Then you will have to be careful. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. You have to walk carefully. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. You will have to walk carefully. You will have to consider your decisions. You will have to consider your words. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. It says that a little folly, hallelujah. Now what is folly? Words. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. It is words that defy a reputation of someone. Praise the name of Jesus. What you say, hallelujah, can make us respect you or despise you. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. So we have to watch over our words. Hallelujah. That is what Jesus Christ told us. He says that it is the words that defile. It is what comes out of a man that defiles a man. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. It is what comes out of you that defiles you. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. It is the thoughts that come out of you that defile your heart. Praise the name of Jesus. It is the words that come out of you that defile the anointing that God has put in your heart. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Now David says in Psalms 23, he says that he anoints my head with oil. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Notice that he anoints my head with oil. Hallelujah. Now where is that anointing? It is in your head. Hallelujah. I was talking about the first level of anointing, which is within you, which every Christian or every believer has. Hallelujah. Now David brings us to another level of anointing. He says that he anoints my head with oil. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. So he knew that the anointing was on his head. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. So because the anointing is in his head, hallelujah, was on his head, it means the enemy was to attack the head, because the anointing is in the head, hallelujah. Now when we're talking about head, we're talking about destiny. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. We are talking about decisions, hallelujah. Just as the writer of Ecclesiastes says, that is the dead flies. Dead flies, mark that word, dead flies that spoil, hallelujah, or bring a stinking savour, or bring a stinking smell, praise the name of Jesus Christ, to the anointing, hallelujah. Are you protecting your anointing? Hallelujah. Are you protecting your anointing? Are you watching over your thoughts? Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Are you watching over what comes into your heart and what comes out of your heart? Are you watching what you say? Praise the name of Jesus Christ. So your words are very vital in your faithfulness. So are you faithful in your anointing? Are you faithful in protecting your anointing? You have to watch over your words. The Bible says that bless always and not curse. Praise the name of Jesus. Bless always and not curse. So that is why we see that David prospered. Hallelujah. Now why am I talking about faithfulness? So your faithfulness will determine how far you will go in life. Hallelujah. Your faithfulness will determine how far you will go in ministry. Your faithfulness will determine how far you will go in salvation. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Now if you compare David and Saul, you will see that one was faithful, the other was unfaithful. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Even though all of them were called by God. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. So we can see that Saul did not go far. Why? Because he did not have faithfulness in him. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. He did not have faithfulness in him. He did not guard his anointing. And because he did not guard his anointing, it was contaminated. Hallelujah. And it started bringing a stinking smell. Hallelujah. Because once your anointing starts bringing a stinking smell, I tell you, any stinking smell repels people away from you. You will start saying that people are rejecting you. No, it is you who has contaminated your anointing. How? By disobedience. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Now that is another enemy of faithfulness. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Now when God sent Saul, hallelujah, to go and destroy the city of Ai and its king and everything that belongs to it, hallelujah, remember that, everything that is in it, the same way God has sent you and I, hallelujah, to go into our soul, hallelujah, the soul I'm talking about is in us, Hallelujah. To destroy every king. Hallelujah. Everything that opposes God. Hallelujah. Now this is what the writer of Corinthians says. He says that we should pull down, hallelujah, every stronghold, hallelujah, every thought, hallelujah, every thought that exalts itself above the knowledge of Jesus Christ. So every thought in you that exalts itself above the knowledge, that is contrary to what the Bible has stated as true, is an enemy. And you have to destroy all of them. Why? Because if you leave one, it is called disobedience. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. We have to expel, we have to destroy every negative attitude that is contrary to what the Bible has told us. Hallelujah. Because if you do not do it, then it means that you have left the King of I alive. Hallelujah. So all those attitudes have to be kept away. All those attitudes have to be killed and make sure that they are all dead. Hallelujah. You know those attitudes that keep people away from Christianity. Hallelujah. Now there are some people whom in their lives, people say that if salvation is what you have, then I better be an unbeliever. Now these are the people who have some kings of I in them. Hallelujah. So beloved of God, you have to kill all of them. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. You have to kill all of them. That is what will determine your faithfulness. Hallelujah. So because Saul did not kill them, he left some. Hallelujah. He left some in his soul. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Those attitudes, that hatred, that unforgiveness that he was showing against David, the man of God, it is what brought his downfall. Hallelujah. It is what rendered him an unfaithful servant. And any unfaithful servant has contaminated the anointing in them. So my question to you today, is your anointing preserved? Is your anointing clean? Is your anointing bringing a fresh smell even unto the people that you come in contact with? Hallelujah. Because if it does not, it means it is expelling people away from Christianity. If it is expelling people away from Christ, then it means you are not a faithful servant. You are not faithful in the anointing that God has given unto you. God has called you into evangelism. Is your evangelism bringing people into Christ? Or are you sitting on your evangelism? Praise the name of Jesus Christ. If you are doing that, it means you are not faithful. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Because that is what disobedience brings a stinking sour to your anointing. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. So ask yourself, are you obedient? Are you obedient? I'm going to talk about complete obedience and incomplete obedience. Incomplete obedience is disobedience. So to bring it to our situation, you have to deal with all those attitudes that are not of God. Hallelujah. Deal with them completely. They have to die. Hallelujah. For the sake of your anointing. Praise the name of Jesus. For the sake of the anointing that God has put into your life. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. You have to obey. Obedience. Very key. You have to obey. Hallelujah. For you to be considered a faithful servant. Now if you go to Philippians chapter 2, it is a common scripture, we have read it. Philippians chapter 2, it tells us of how the Lord was faithful. Hallelujah. That's why he is the firstborn. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. He is the firstborn. Praise the name of Jesus. We call that he is the firstborn of the faithful. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. We are talking about faithfulness. Hallelujah. Amen. We are talking about faithfulness. So we are going to move first to Hebrews. Hebrews 12 and verse 22. We are talking about Jesus Christ, who is the faithful witness. The Bible says, we're going to start from 22. The Bible says, but you are come unto Mount Zion, praise the name of Jesus, unto the city of the living God, the heavenly Jerusalem, unto an innumerable company of angels, to the general assembly and church of the firstborn. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Church of the firstborn. Hallelujah. Now you should ask yourself, what did the firstborn do? Hallelujah. What did he do? And who is this firstborn? Now we can see clearly, the Bible says the general assembly and church of the firstborn. Now the firstborn is Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. The firstborn is Jesus Christ. So there is an assembly of firstborn. An assembly of people who are faithful. Jesus Christ was faithful to the Father. Praise the name of Jesus. He was faithful to the calling which was upon his life. Praise the name of Jesus. But the Bible says in Philippians 2, the Bible says, even though he was in the same form as God, he did not consider it robbery to be equal with God. But the Bible says he humbled himself. Hallelujah. Do you want to be faithful? You must humble yourself. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Do you want to be faithful to your calling? Do you want to be faithful with the mandate that God has given unto your life? Hallelujah. You have to be humble. The Bible says that he humbled himself even to the point of death. That is where humility can take you sometimes. That is where humility can drive you to the lowest places of this society. Hallelujah. But I tell you, the Bible has given us an assurance. The firstborn means he is our pattern. What he went through, you will go through. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. The level of despise that he went through because of his faithfulness. The Bible says that God has lifted him up high above every name. Hallelujah. High above every power. Praise the name of Jesus. That at the name of Jesus Christ, every knee must bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of the Father in heaven. So do you want to be promoted? Then you must be faithful. Hallelujah to your calling. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. You want elevation. You want to be promoted. You must be faithful. Just as I began by saying that it does not matter where you are. You can be faithful where you are right now. You can be faithful in that gift of prayer that God has given unto you. You can be faithful in that gift of exhortation that God has given you. So launch out, hallelujah. Apply, hallelujah. Apply that faith. Make it into an action. And I tell you, you are going to be considered one of those people who are called faithful. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. To the general assembly of the church, hallelujah. To the general assembly and church of the firstborn. Now, who was that firstborn? Jesus Christ. What made him firstborn? Faithfulness. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Now, you want to be in that assembly, hallelujah, of the people that are living in Jerusalem, to the people that have been elevated from the physical Jerusalem to the heavenly Jerusalem. Praise the name of Jesus. You want to be elevated by God. Spiritually, you have to be faithful. It is not an option. It is a must, hallelujah, that we be faithful. Even as Jesus Christ, who is the firstborn, who is our elder brother, who was faithful to his calling. Hallelujah. So, as I say, it does not matter. Where you are does not matter. Does not affect your faithfulness. Your faithfulness depends with you. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. It is you to make that decision. Am I going to be faithful or am I not? Praise the name of Jesus. Because now I can remember when Jesus Christ in the parable of the talent, the Bible says that he gave them talent. Hallelujah. Some increased them. Now what is that increase? That talent brought people into the kingdom. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. That is the profit. Hallelujah. That Jesus Christ is telling us about. The profit. It has to benefit the kingdom. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. So is your calling benefiting the kingdom? Is the gift that the Lord has put in your life benefiting the kingdom? Is your ministry benefiting the kingdom of God? If it is not benefiting the kingdom of God, then you are not a faithful servant. And the danger of that is that if you are not faithful in the kingdom of God, then you are not worthy to be in the kingdom of God. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. And this is what my Bible tells me. It tells me that that unfaithful servant was taken and thrown where there is weeping and gnashing of teeth. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Now that tells me that is utter darkness. That is total separation. Hallelujah. From the grace and from the glory, from the power and from the life of God. Hallelujah. So do you want to be closer to the life of God? Then be faithful. Do you want to be closer to the life of God? I tell you, beloved, you have to be faithful with that which the Lord has put into your hands. Now the question is, what has God put into your hands? It might be very small. It might be a child. It might be a husband that God has put into your hands. Are you faithful? Hallelujah. Are you faithful with that husband? Are you faithful with that wife? Are you faithful with that child that God has put into your hands? Because if you're not faithful, I tell you, you will have to give an account even at the great white judgment throne. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. And everyone has to give an account. Now the question is, what will you give? Hallelujah. What will that which God has given unto you, will it have brought a profit to God? Or will it have remained just as God gave it to you? Are you increasing? That is the question. Are you increasing in the thing that God has given unto you? Are you increasing them? Are you bettering their lives? Are you bettering your life, the life that God has given unto you right now? Is it better or is it becoming worse? Because if it is becoming worse, it means then you are not faithful. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Faithfulness is a must for a child of God, for you to be in the kingdom. Now we are talking about the kingdom of God. Just as I said, you have to couple faithfulness with the kingdom of God. Bible says that he that does not carry his cross, hallelujah, is not worthy to be my disciple. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. It will take tough decisions, hallelujah, for you to be faithful. Hallelujah. It will take you to leave some things behind for you to be faithful. Hallelujah. It will take you to leave some things behind for you to be faithful. Now the Bible says in Revelation, it says that they overcame him, hallelujah, by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. Now this is where the point comes in. The Bible says, and they loved not their lives even unto death. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Now what will determine your faithfulness? You have to lay down your life. Praise the name of Jesus. You have to lay down your life for you to be a faithful servant of Jesus Christ. Now you cannot be a faithful servant of Jesus Christ if you are still holding on to your life. The Bible says that he that keeps his life will lose it, but he that gives his life for the sake of the kingdom of God, he shall get it. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Do you want to lose your life or do you want to get your life? Hallelujah. You have to give something up. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. There are some things you'll have to give up. There are some friends you'll have to give up. There are some attitudes you'll have to give up. There are some words you will have to give up. There are some places you will have to give up. Praise the name of Jesus. There are some behaviors you will have to give up for you to be counted faithful. Now, because if you are not counted faithful, I tell you, there is no place for you in the heavenly Jerusalem. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Let me repeat that one more time. The Bible says, but you come unto Mount Zion. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. And to the city of the living God, the heavenly Jerusalem, and to an innumerable company of angels. Praise the name of God. To the general assembly and church of the firstborn, which are written in heaven. So which are these people who are written in heaven? The faithful. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. They that are faithful with the faith that God has given unto them. They that are faithful with the salvation, the gift of salvation that God has given unto them. So the question is, are you faithful with your salvation or are you despising your birthright? Because if you despise your birthright, I tell you, it is going to be taken away from you and it's going to be given to someone that values it. Praise the name of Jesus Christ, which are written in heaven, and to God the judge of all. So it is very much connected with judgment. If you are not faithful, I tell you, you will not pass that judgment. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. And weeping and separation awaits the unfaithful. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. So that is something that we need to think about as children of God. Do you want to be in the kingdom of God? Do you want to be counted worthy? Praise the name of Jesus Christ, in the presence of God. Do you want Jesus Christ to say that great, well done, faithful servant? Do you want that to be the testimony that shall come from the mouth of the Lord concerning you? Is that the testimony? Are you longing for it? Now, if you're longing for it, you're going to do something. As I say, faith with your diligence will bring power, which is virtue. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Do you want to release that power? Because once power is released in your life, people shall come to Christ. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. We can see that from the life of the apostles. the people walked in power. And I tell you, people increased, the church increased in thousands. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Because they were diligent. Hallelujah. Now for you to be faithful, you have to deal with laziness. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Laziness has to leave. Hallelujah. It has to leave your mind. It has to leave your salvation. It has to leave your prayer life. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. It has to leave your meditation life for you to increase your faith, for you to be counted faithful. Because once you are counted faithful, you are added. Hallelujah. The gift is added. Praise the name of Jesus. But the Bible says, to your faith, add. Hallelujah. To your faith, add virtue. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. That is the faith. That is what God wants with your faith. Your faith has to be mature. It was given to you as a seed, and it has to be a tree. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. It has to be a tree. A tree that bears fruit. And those fruit must remain. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. The Bible says that that tree that did not bear fruit, that tree was unfaithful to the one who planted it. Now what would that planter do? It was to cast that tree because it was unfaithful. It was unfruitful to him. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Do you want God to prune you so that you can bear much fruit? Or do you want a curse because you are not faithful? Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Now your fruit has to remain. You have to bear fruit. You have to consider the faith that God has given unto you. You have to consider every gift that God has given unto you, that it is increasing. Hallelujah. Because that is the lot of those who are faithful. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. It does not determine where you are. Your faithfulness, it is what will bring you to be transported to the place where you are, to the place of promotion. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Even as Jesus Christ was promoted, you shall be promoted likewise. If you are faithful, if you are obedient, praise the name of Jesus Christ. If you do not despise your birthright, that which God has put into your life, praise the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. I'm going to finish with this verse. Now this is a message of Jesus Christ to the churches. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. So I say, it does not matter where you are. It does not matter where you are. Hallelujah. You still can be faithful where you are right now. Praise the name of Jesus. You can be faithful. Now, Revelations 2 are from verse 12. Now, this is the message of Jesus Christ to the church of Pergamos. Hallelujah. So I want to bring to our attention the condition of the church, the condition of the people that were in this church, the condition of the people that were in this place. These people suffered greatly. Hallelujah. But they still held their faithfulness. Praise the name of Jesus. Revelation 2 and verse 12. The Bible says, unto the angel of the church in Pergamos, write, this thing says he which has the sharp sword with two edges. I know your works. Hallelujah. And where you dwell. I know where you dwell. I know your situation. I know your condition at this very particular time. That is Jesus Christ speaking. I know your condition. I know where you dwell, even where Satan's seat is. Hallelujah. Now that is what I want to bring to our attention. Imagine those people were in the throne, were in that place where Satan had put his throne. So you can imagine the persecution. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. The Bible says that even where Satan's seat is, and you hold fast my name, praise the name of Jesus Christ, and have not denied my faith. Hallelujah. Even in those days, wherein Antipas was my faithful martyr. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Who was slain among you where Satan dwells. Hallelujah. So we can see that Antipas was faithful even unto death. He did not consider his life even unto death. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. For the sake of the kingdom of God. For the sake of the name of Jesus Christ. So it did not matter where Antipas was. It did not matter where he was, in the very place where the enemy had put his throne. He was still faithful. So my question for us today, or my message for you today, is that it does not matter where you are, you still can be faithful. It does not matter what you are going through, you still can be faithful. It does not matter your financial situation, you can still be faithful in your finances. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. It does not matter where you are in your health, you still can praise God. You still can lift up your voice and glorify the name of Jesus Christ. You still can be faithful in your worship. You still can be faithful in your prayers. Because it does not matter where you are, provided you stay faithful to the one who called you. Put your focus upon he who called you. Put your focus upon he who called you. And I tell you, you will stand whatsoever the enemy can bring into your life. The Bible says that nothing, absolutely nothing, can separate us from the love of God. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. It is not angels, it is not tribulation, it is not hunger, it is not nakedness. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. The Bible says, because if God is for you, then who can be against you? Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Beloved, we have to stay in that place of faithfulness. Hallelujah. And the Lord, who is faithful, shall do even as he has promised. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. I believe that word has blessed you. God bless you. God bless you. Thank you so much for your attention. Hallelujah.
Amen. 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 Yeah, we thank God for